Hi everybody, welcome to another episode of Exploring Photography right here on Adorama TV. I'm Mark Wallace, and in today's episode, I'm going to give you three techniques for editing video in Adobe Premiere Pro that will save you a ton of time, specifically when it comes to syncing audio to video. So here is the scenario. The first one is if you have a really cool audio track with some beats to it, and you want to make your cuts line up with those beats to the music. So bum, 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 you want to cut every single time. So I'm going to show you how to do that automatically. It's pretty cool. The second thing I want to show you how to do is to automatically align audio tracks from different video takes. So maybe you have a camera A and a camera B, and they both have audio, and you want to synchronize them. You can do that with automation, or if you have an audio recording only and you want to sync that to a video recording, maybe you have an external audio recorder, you can also do that automatically. And then I've got a bonus technique that I'll show you that helps you apply attributes to a bunch of clips all at once. So let's dive into Adobe Premiere Pro right now. And what I'm going to show you how to do first is something called Automate to Sequence. Now, here's the scenario. I've got this really cool audio track. Listen to this. Okay, so it's not so cool, but it's some great stock music. And what I want to do is I want to have some B-roll automatically edited to those beats. So boom, 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 boom. On the beat, I want those to cut automatically. So here's what I'm going to do. The first thing I want to do is add some markers to my sequence where those beats are. Now you can add a marker to a sequence just by hitting M, the M key. So I'll hit the M key right now. That puts a marker right at the beginning of the sequence. You can see that right here. There's a little marker there. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna play this audio clip, and on the beat, I'm gonna hit M, just like I'm playing an instrument. Bump, 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 bump. And so I'll do that right now. And then once I have that done, we'll start again. Okay, so I just fast-forwarded through that so it wouldn't take a bunch of time, but again, I just hit the M key on the beat, and there was one little section here that goes a little bit faster. You can hear it. So I bap-ba-da-da-bap-bap-bap on the M key to add a bunch of little markers there. Okay, so now you can see that we have this markers on the sequence here. Now, one thing that's very important to note that when you're doing this, make sure you don't have a clip selected, because then it'll put markers on the clip. You don't want that. You want the markers on the sequence. So make sure there's no clips, nothing selected when you do that. Okay, the next thing we want to do is put the playhead right back to the very beginning of our music. And then make sure we unselect that. Now we're gonna go find some B-roll that will go to this. So I've got a little folder here called B-roll. And what I've done here is I've gone to each of these little clips and I've set an in and an out point. So every single little clip here has an in and an out. That's just the segment of video that I want to have played when I automate this. Now another thing to remember here is this has audio and video. So if I play just a short clip, you can hear some audio that's pretty useless. I don't want that audio when this goes onto the music. I just want the video. All right, so here's how it works. What I'm going to do, remember I have an in and out set for each of these already. I've already done that to my B-roll. I'm gonna go and select all of these clips. There's a bunch of clips here, I don't know how many. Then I'm going to go up to clip, and then there's this little thing here called automate to sequence. I will click that, and then I have some options. So the thing I want to do here is I want to use the sort order. In other words, that is the order that they appear in the list over here in my B-roll bin. I could do that, or the selection order. That's the order that they're gonna go on the timeline. So if you wanna do this manually, you can select them one at a time, hitting, you know, holding down the shift and click, 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 and getting all those, and you can sort of do the order, or you can just do it by the sort order of the bin. That's what I'm going to do. Now, the placement is going to be at the unnumbered markers. That's all those little markers that we put on our sequence. Those are all there. And then the method, we want to use an overwrite edit, because we don't want to have a cut in our music and throw them in between that. We just want to put it on top of the music. So that's an overwrite. It's going to go over that. Now, the other thing we want to do is how long is the duration of each of these things? Well, we're going to use our in and out range. So I've made these in and outs about 5 to 10 seconds, something like that. If they're too long, that's okay. It'll just start at the end and end at the next marker. If they're too short, that's okay. We can go in and tweak that a little bit. But you want to have an in and out. And then the other thing I want to do here at the very bottom is it will say, do you want to ignore the audio or ignore the video or ignore neither of those things? So I want to ignore the audio. So I don't want to have the audio go to the timeline because I want to use the music. That's the whole point. I want to get rid of the audio from my B-roll, and then I just want to use the music and put the video on top of that. So I'm saying ignore audio, don't use that. Now, here's the magic. All I'm going to do is hit OK, boom, and check this out. I will click play. And so it's awesome. It's automatically cut each of those little chunks of B-roll to the markers that I've put on my timeline. Now I'm going to fast forward over here because there was a little clip that had some really fast beats, kind of thing, and I hit the M key to try to match those, and watch how fast this goes, and it's done automatically. It works. All right, so that's technique number one. If you need a refresher, just rewind, hit pause, look at all those different menu options, practice this, and you'll be doing it all on your own. The second technique allows you to automatically synchronize audio and video. Now, this is great if you have an audio track from a mobile audio recording device, and then you have a video that doesn't have great audio, and you want to take one and use that over the other one. This is done all the time. Or if you have several cameras, and you want to synchronize them so that they're playing all together so you can edit between those. So let's do the first one really quickly. So what I have here is I have an audio track. This is just me talking.
Here on Adorama TV, I'm Mark Wallace, and in this episode...
Okay, that was recorded on a Zoom H4 recorder, I believe. And then the other thing I have here is a video of me, and this was recorded at the same time.
Of Adorama TV that I've created.
Okay, and so this video was recorded with a little Osmo Pocket, so the audio, the built-in audio wasn't very good, so I used an external audio recorder. So let's synchronize those. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my video with the not-so-good audio track and put that on my timeline. I'm going to keep the existing settings. I'm editing this in 1080p, even though I shot it in 4K. And then I'm going to take my audio track, and then I'm just going to put that on the timeline. It doesn't matter where it is, just as long as it's on the timeline. Then I'm going to select both of those, right click, and say synchronize. Then it's going to ask me what I want to use to synchronize these clips. I want to use the audio. I'll use the mix down channel, hit OK. It is going to go through and process those, and look, now they are synced. So if I play this back,
hi everybody, welcome to another episode of Exploring.
The audio and video is synced. Now what I want to do here is I'll just go in right at the end point. I'll use my little razor tool to trim off the first part of that. We don't need that part. Then I'm going to go into this track here. I'm going to unlink them and I'm going to delete the bad audio track. I'll move up the good audio track, select both of those, and then link them, boom, just like that.
Hi everybody, welcome to another episode of Exploring Photography right here.
All right, just like that, I have great audio from an external recorder synced to great video from my video camera, and it works just fine. Well, let's talk about the second scenario where you might have three cameras or so and you want to synchronize those so that they all play together and you can edit between them. It works the same way. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna delete what I just did. I have three cameras that I've used here. I've got a GoPro that I used for B-roll. I've got an Osmo Pocket that I used for B-roll. And then I have a Sony camera that I used as my main camera.
At least at a basic level. The next thing.
So I want to synchronize all those things. So all I have to do is I'll take my Sony, that's the master camera. I'll put that on the timeline. I'm going to use my existing settings, again, editing in 1080p. Then I'll take my Osmo Pocket. I'll throw that, it doesn't matter where, on the timeline. Then I'll take my GoPro, boom, and I'll throw this on the timeline. Now I want these, if I play this right now, him sitting this way, the audio is all crazy. And so what I'll do is I'll highlight everything, right click, hit synchronize. I'll use the same options as before and hit okay. And blam, everything is synced. Now what I can do is I can do exactly what I did before. I'll take these two clips. I will unlink the audio and video. I will delete the bad video. I'll get a razor tool, and then I will just slice everything here. Bonk. All right. So now what I can do is I'll hide these other ones. You can see
our lens flare.
There's our first camera angle. I'll put this on here.
Level. The next thing we need to do.
The second camera angle is synced.
So when our model gets here, we're going to have him.
Here's the GoPro camera. And so then I can go and edit through these and it'll be just fine. Now that's not the best way to do that. If you're doing multiple cameras, that's just a really down, quick and dirty way. You want to use multicam editing if it's possible. But in a pinch, the synchronize option works really, really well. All right, let's talk about the third thing that can save you a ton of time. So this is copy and paste attributes. So look at what I have here. I've got a 4K timeline, but I shot some video from a Mavic and I used two different 4K formats. And so you can see here on this first clip that we've got black bars because it's the wrong aspect ratio. So that's the same with the first, the second, and the third clip, but then I fixed everything so it's in a normal aspect ratio on the rest of these clips. So I need to fix these first four video clips. And so I don't want to do those over and over one at a time. And this really will impact you if you have, let's say, like 30 or 40 clips and you have to do the same change to all of those. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to open this first clip and I'll just make some changes. It doesn't matter what changes you make. You can make these automated as well. So I'm just going to scale this up to 100 so that it fits my 4K format. And then I'm going to add some, some really wacky color processing just to make this really obvious. So I think what I'll do here is I'll put a really giant vignette on there. I'll make it less round. I'll take the midpoint way down. I'll take the feather. Okay, so you can see that I've added something to this. All right, so now what I want to do, I'll go back to my editing workspace, is I want to apply this wacky effect to everything else here. It looks like I've also changed. Okay, yeah, there it is. So I want to apply this to these other three clips. So all I have to do is go into edit and then I'll say copy. And then I will select these three clips right here that I want to copy all of the changes that I just made. I will go to edit. I will say paste attribute. Then I can choose which attributes to paste. So I want to paste the motion. So that's the scaling, the size that I did. I want to also paste the effects. So that's all the stuff I did with the vignette. You can also choose or not choose other things as well, but those are the ones I want to paste. So I'll hit okay, bonk, just like that. Now look, all of these other video clips also have that same wacky effect added to them. And I just had to do it to one, copy and paste all those attributes. So those are three techniques that could save you a ton of time, specifically the audio stuff. I hope that helps you out. And I want to say thank you so much for joining me for this episode of Exploring Photography. Don't forget to subscribe to Adorama TV because we're uploading videos all the time, not just here on YouTube, but over on Instagram as well. You don't want to miss out on that. Make sure you click the bell so you get notifications of when all that goodness is coming to you. And also, if you want to have a little sneak peek for some behind the scenes footage of what I'm doing, well, follow me over on Instagram. So I'm uploading Instagram stories all the time of when I'm recording videos and all the stuff I'm doing as I'm traveling around the world. Well, thanks again for joining me, and I will see you again next time.